Welcome to USC Commencement. For your safety, please be aware of the following guidelines. In the unlikely event of an earthquake, remember to drop, cover, and hold in place, then calmly await further instructions from safety personnel. If you should see anything out of the ordinary, please notify a security officer or a commencement staff member. For emergency assistance, contact the USC Department of Public Safety at 213-740-4321. Thank you for your attention. Enjoy your day at USC, and congratulations to all our graduates.
Good afternoon, family and friends. Welcome. My name is Nora Sandoval. I'm the Executive Director for Student Engagement in the Viterbi Admission and Student Engagement Office, as our students know it as FACE, and I will be your MC for this ceremony. Thank you all for being here. Please take a moment to silence your phones and refrain from noises that could compromise the experience of others. So with that, let's get this started. Please welcome the graduates from Aerospace and Mechanical Engineering. Welcome the graduates from the Daniel J. Epstein Department of Industrial and Systems Engineering. Thank you. Now welcome the graduates from the Sonia Stani Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering. Please welcome the graduates from the Mingxie Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering.
Thank you.
the graduates of Green Technologies. Welcome the graduates from Astronautical Engineering. And the graduates of Systems, Architecting, and Engineering. Welcome to graduates from Biomedical Engineering. Welcome the graduates from the Mork Family Department of Chemical Engineering and Materials Science. Welcome the graduates from Petroleum Engineering. Thank you. graduates, families, and guests, welcome to the University of Southern California Viterbi School of Engineering 2022 Graduate Commencement Ceremony. I now ask everyone to rise for our faculty processional. I'm very pleased to introduce our ceremony participants. Special guest and retired general Ellen Palakowski. Yannis C. Yortzos, Dean, USC Viterbi School of Engineering. Majid Dasauki, Professor and Chair of the Daniel J. Epstein Department of Industrial and Systems Engineering. Paul Ronnie, Professor and Chair, Department of Aerospace and Mechanical Engineering. Richard Leahy, Professor and Chair, the Mingxie Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering. Francisco Valero Cuevas, Professor, Department of Biomedical Engineering. Tony Levy, Professor and Chair of the Mingxie Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering. Bertrand Bezerik Gerber, Professor and Chair of the Sani Istani Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering. Michael Koo, Professor and Interim Chair of the Department of Biomedical Engineering. Joseph Wang, Professor, Department of Astronautical Engineering. Noah Momstead, Professor and Associate Chair of the Mork Family Department of Chemical Engineering and Material Science. Eric Johnson, Vice Dean of Academic Programs, USC Viterbi School of Engineering. Araja Shaghi, Professor and Director of Petroleum Engineering. Kelly Goulis, Senior Associate Dean, Viterbi Admission and Student Engagement. Kim Bergenzer, Vice Dean for Administration and Finance, the Viterbi School of Engineering. Ken Bonner, Associate Dean, Inclusion and Diversity Initiatives, the Viterbi School of Engineering. And Patricia Garcia, Student Commencement Speaker, Product Development Engineering from the Daniel J. Epstein Department of Industrial and Systems Engineering. Please be seated and turn your attention to the screens for a special presentation.
I think the major difference between my undergrad background and my master's degree level right now,
I didn't necessarily focus on my technical abilities. I knew that my work experience and my training would be okay in that. I think that
doing my master's at USC has broadened my view of the engineering problems.
My original major is civil engineering, but I think that's not enough for me.
Viterbi has empowered me to think a little bit more in an entrepreneurial sense.
So I study, I'm thinking like, maybe I can do more.
It's about bringing engineering to the people that cannot have, that don't have a voice.
And marrying technical skills with the current problems that the world is facing.
I'd like to make a change in this world by creating technology that helps everybody.
As long as you're presenting a product or service that's essentially making a difference, not just for the marginalized communities, but inclusive of all, I think you're doing good in the world.
Just make a difference in one person's life, and that would be good enough for me.
So Viterbi has always helped me push the boundaries and think of the bigger picture.
I think I got better at collaborating and communicating with people from different experience level, education and cultural background. And I think those soft skills are very important for me to go into workplace and taking more challenges for society.
But most importantly, I've been able to do what engineers do best. We create, we break, and we build again.
I think that was the original intent of engineering, to be builders and to be, you know, to open doors for others. So I'm glad to say that Viterbi has allowed me to do that.
Fight on.
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 Please welcome the Dean of the USC Viterbi School of Engineering, Yannis C. Yortzos.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the 2022 Viterbi Graduate Commencement. It's so wonderful to see all of you here today on this important day, this in-person encounter. We haven't had this for quite a while, and it is so great to see that we have this in-person ceremony 3 years after we had the last one. We're here to celebrate you and your outstanding accomplishments. Commencement is a wonderful time of the year. For all of us, it's a time of new beginnings and goodbyes to all students and friends. Students graduate and carry with them all the rich experiences they accumulated over the year from their interactions with our faculty and their colleagues. In the fall, new students will join us, and this cycle will recommence. It's this renewal process, the farewell to graduates and the welcome to the new ones, that we commemorate every year at different times of the year. I want to congratulate each and every one of you on the singular achievement of earning a graduate degree from USC Viterbi, which, as you know, ranks among the best in the country. I am sure you had more than a few worry-filled, sleepless nights along the way, but I also know that it was worth the effort. You're joining a distinguished club of some of the world's most dynamic technology and thought leaders. Our feelings this year are even stronger because this graduating class is the best so far, the best educated, the most representative in our history. Yes. And I think I may have to say this again next year. About 33% of the graduates here today are women. They represent the changing face of engineering for the better, what we do, who we are, and what we look like. It was more than 2 years ago when I have said in jest, paralleling quantum mechanics, that as COVID descended upon us, the wave function collapsed. And we joined a dark COVID world. Now, I'm not a quantum mechanicist, and so what I say may actually be not really well received by the experts. But at this time, I think we are about to the situation at which the proverbial wave function is about to collapse yet again, and hopefully will enter the post-COVID world. One we hope is full of promise and opportunity for endless innovation, one that you are better equipped to shape than any graduating classes ever before, and that's true. In this incredible experiment the world undertook during the pandemic, we learned how important is science and engineering to help bring an end to the contagion and make our lives better. And the post-COVID world ahead provides incredible opportunities of an unpainted canvas on which you will be asked to imagine the new engineering and technology innovation, one which increasingly will have human-centric focus. The world impatiently waits for you, and you're ideally prepared for it. It will be you who will address the grand challenges the world faces, whether it is making solar energy economical, securing cyberspace, engineering better medicines, providing access to clean water, addressing vexing climate change issues, or feeding the hungry. As graduates, you join a pantheon of USC Viterbi alums that would be the envy of many universities. I would like to mention that they include Neil Armstrong, the first human to walk on the moon, Andrew Viterbi, the namesake of our school, the Viterbi algorithm, a co-founder of Qualcomm, former Aerospace Corporation's chief executive and former USC president, Wanda Austin, Apple co-founder Mike Markula, Charles Bolden, former chief administrator of NASA, and many more. I look forward to one day adding your name to this distinguished list. I am confident that future Viterbi leaders will speak lonely about the contributions of the class of 2022, whose members come from 29 countries around the globe. including South Korea, Saudi Arabia, not to mention a few small countries like China and India. Over 120 of our Viterbi master's graduates maintain a perfect 4.0 GPA. Now, as you know, I have said before that a 4.0 engineering GPA is like a 6.0 business GPA, if you know what I mean. No offense to our business colleagues. We also have 12 military-connected students who are graduating this year. ...168 students have earned degrees via DEN at Viterbi, our nationally highly ranked distance education program. In summer 2016, we actually engaged in a unique partnership with Saudi Aramco to identify a select cohort of engineers to enroll on our Masters of Construction Management program. They were selected to apply for this program through the same strict Viterbi criteria for admissions, as with all our programs. We started this cohort in 2016. After the success of our first cohort, we had a new cohort that started, and these are students who applied for admission in spring 2020. The second cohort was consisting of 23 engineering students enrolled in 10 courses over 5 semesters. Due to COVID-19, the Plan On-Site program pivoted to a 100% online interactive program, thanks to the support of our DEN at Viterbi and the flexibility of faculty and students. I must say that sessions sometimes began at 4 or 5 a.m. in Los Angeles, allowing for continued conversation and engagement between Los Angeles and the Middle East. This cohort demonstrates the determination and commitment of our DEN at Viterbi community to education. We want to commend the graduates, both those who are here today, as well as those who were unable to come to LA, for the tremendous accomplishment to completing your master's degree. So, warmest congratulations to you too. I speak to you not only as the Dean of the School of Engineering, but also as a parent of two Viterbi students, one of whom actually got a master's degree as well in industrial and systems engineering. And your journey at USC, all of you, has become possible by the constant care and support from the most important people who are gathered here today. And these are your parents, your families, and your friends. So on a day in which you're rightly the center of attention, I'd like to ask you, graduates, to rise and join me in a round of applause for those who have supported you each and every step, your family and friends. I would like also to thank from this podium the 9 graduating executive board members and senators who serve on the Viterbi Graduate Student Association, VGSA. Thank you to Prasan Prasad, Julianne Johnson, Diego Giacomi, Lakshmi Ramesh, Pragathi Kurapati, Aleya Rognandil, Aditya Joshi, Vinithan Gandhi, and Tanvi Kansuri. Congratulations and thank you. And now it's my pleasure to introduce our commencement student speaker, Patricia Garcia, who will graduate today with a Master's in Product Development Engineering. A 2021 GEM Fellow, she has combined her interest in engineering, entrepreneurship, and design through her startup, Unithrifts, a gamified platform creating a model of circular consumption on college campuses across the U.S., starting with collegiate gear. Patricia has pitched at a number of high-profile events, including the Oracle for Startups Next Gen HQ Cloud Challenge, where she was crowned the national winner. She's built in Unithrifts on 3 key pillars: accessibility, sustainability, and community, with a goal of expanding and diversifying what sustainability looks like on college campuses across the US with the incorporation of tech for good. Patricia.
Thank you, Dean Yortsos.
Good afternoon, distinguished guests, faculty, family, friends, and of course, the class of 2022. The day is finally here. We made it. My name is Patricia Garcia from Miami, Florida, and it's an honor to stand before you all as your student commencement speaker. Today, we gather as proud Trojans, over hundreds of us preparing to walk this very stage, representing 7 academic departments here in the city of Los Angeles. I know there's no way for me to condense all of our experiences here at Viterbi into a single narrative, so instead, I'll share a bit of my story and hope that it'll resonate with some of your experiences here. I recently came across a photo in my camera roll of a very colorful scrapbook page that detailed the future plans 10-year-old Patricia had for herself. Like most children's scrapbooks, the fill-in-the-blank prompts ask you, where do you predict you'll be in 5, 10, 15 years, etc.? My 10 years note read the following. In 10 years, I will be an actress on Disney Channel and be the most famous. Clearly, as your student speaker today at one of the nation's top engineering schools alongside you all, you can probably tell what happened with that. However, you can probably tell I had very big dreams for the future from a very young age. But this would usually be followed with 2 words, no inventes. This common Spanish phrase translates to don't get any crazy ideas or don't go in over your head. As a child, I was always inventando, contrary to my Cuban-American mother's wishes, and always eager for what tomorrow would bring. Growing up in Miami, Florida, this maybe looked like walking out to my porch during a hurricane just to see it with my own eyes, or walking or swimming to the end of Miami Beach. 13 years later, I reflect on the impact this siempre inventando character coupled with my forward-looking mentality has had on my time here at USC. My journey to SC began with this forward-looking mentality as my time in undergrad was always with an eye towards graduate school. In 2019, while still a junior in high school, I participated in the REACH program, which is a fly-in program focused on offering underrepresented students in engineering the opportunity to get firsthand exposure on what pursuing higher education in engineering could look like. At that time, attending an institution like USC seemed quite unattainable, academically and financially, coming from a large public school. Schools like USC were those that you only saw in movies that were reserved for people who I was not. I remember thinking to myself, this might be the only time I ever visit Los Angeles. However, I stand before you to tell a very different story. When the 2021 graduate school application cycle came to an end, like many of you, I had options when it came to deciding what institution I would call home for my graduate studies. Sure, I looked into the US News and World Report ranking of Viterbi's graduate engineering program, which we all know ranks quite high, but I knew I wanted my graduate school experience to be much more than that. A strong engineering program was just as important to me as an entrepreneurial campus ecosystem that would foster innovative interdisciplinary collaboration. And Viterbi offered just that. During my time at SC as a GEM Fellow in the Daniel J. Epstein Department of Industrial and Systems Engineering, I've accomplished more than I could have ever imagined as an entrepreneurial engineer. My time in the classroom learning at Viterbi has allowed me to build a system perspective to collaborate across disciplines and design innovative human-centered solutions to various 21st century challenges. One learning that will stick with me long after my time here is the idea that innovation is best when it includes a diversity of thought and experiences. This means embracing more than the title which your degree will read today, which ultimately makes you a more well-rounded individual. And I've applied exactly this with my outside-of-the-classroom endeavors. I am the founder of UniThrifts, which is a gamified platform creating a model of circular consumption on college campuses across the US, starting specifically now with college gear. What started off as a social media platform to test some assumptions has today rerouted over 1,000 pounds of waste from landfills with only an MVP and recently launched on iOS and Android. This success has not gone unnoticed. To date, UniThrifts has won over 20 national pitch competitions, raised thousands in non-dilutive funding, and gained national press coverage. Thank you.
Most recently, I had the opportunity to represent the student entrepreneurial talent at Viterbi as the national winner of the Oracle for Startups Next Gen HQ Challenge, focused on leveraging the cloud to improve student life on campuses across the U.S. It's not every day that engineering lands you courtside seats to a Golden State Warriors game while also pitching your startup to Oracle executives. Ultimately, embracing an engineering plus mindset, as coined by Dean Yortzos, has opened opportunities for me that once seemed unimaginable. However, I would not have been able to accomplish any of this alone. It would be remiss of me not to acknowledge the support systems I've come to find at USC who have made Los Angeles home. Behind every one of my accomplishments thus far, I credit the amazing community of people I have found here, especially my Society of Hispanic Professional Engineers grad squad, who welcomed me into the familia before even stepping foot at USC. The support and encouragement I've received from the gradship familia has been unparalleled. These individuals are the type of people that speak your name in a crowded room full of opportunities. When you look back at your SC experience, who was your familia? Who were your greatest champions? What does your USC journey tell? Sure, the tailgates, football games, and all these things are quite memorable experiences, but this community and this family is what makes USC unlike any other. Class of 2022, we've had to face a multitude of barriers to get to this point, but our unrelenting will to succeed persevered. Standing here today, despite all the setbacks and obstacles we may have faced, because of our drive and resilience, it is clear that our willpower to endure is stronger than any deterrent. Today, we will graduate from the illustrious University of Southern California, Viterbi School of Engineering, which signifies a beginning of a new page in your scrapbook. However, it's up to us to decide what fills these next pages. But I'd like to think as engineers trained here at USC, we have a distinct advantage. As graduates, we've been given the tools to design and build the technologies of tomorrow to help people live better lives. We can solve the grand challenges plaguing our world. We can create the next Fortune 500 company. Upon receiving our degrees today, we will share an alma mater with that of the first person to walk on the moon, the co-founder of the largest wireless technology company, and so many other trailblazing Trojans. Whether you will continue on your educational journey or begin your dream job, this next stage of your life is a new page in your scrapbook, a blank canvas, an unaddressed envelope. What story will you tell? Congratulations, class of 2022, and fight on.
Thanks so much. And now, I would like to introduce our keynote speaker for the commencement address, General Ellen Polikowski. General retired Ellen Polikowski is the Judge Whitney Professor at the Viterbi School of Engineering at USC. She serves on the board of directors for the Raytheon Company Applied Research Associates and SRI International. General Polikowski was the third woman to achieve the rank of general in the U.S. Air Force. In her last assignment, she served as commander, Air Force Materiel Command, Wright-Patterson Air Force Base, Ohio. That command employs some 80,000 people and manages $60 billion annually, providing the Air Force with research and development, life cycle systems management, test and evaluation, installation support, depot maintenance, and supply chain management. She entered the Air Force in 1978 as a distinguished graduate of the ROTC program at the New Jersey Institute of Technology. She then attended UC Berkeley as a Fannie and John Hertz Foundation Fellow and received a doctorate in chemical engineering. General Polikowski is nationally recognized for her leadership and technical management acumen. Among her recognitions are Women in Aerospace Lifetime Achievement Award, the NDI's Peter B. Tietz Award, the Air Force Association Executive Management Award, and she also is a member of the National Academy of Engineering. She's an honorary fellow of the American Institute of Astronautics and Aeronautics, a fellow of the Directed Energy Professional Society, and as I mentioned, a member of the NAE. Please welcome to the podium General Ellen Polikowski.
Well, let me begin by first thanking Dean Yurtsos and the faculty and staff of Viterbi for allowing me to participate in this celebration of achievement. You know, since joining the Trojan family in the fall of 2019, I've not had many opportunities to do this. And it is just great to see faces instead of a den screen. I loved it as you were walking in. I teach in the system architecting and systems engineering class, and I eagerly applauded as you graduates walked in, trying to look at your faces so that I could see if I could recognize some of you. But without hearing your voices, I can't. But this is so wonderful to be able to be here and to celebrate this with you. A hearty congratulations to all of you. This is really a successful completion of a very, very rigorous program. It's a significant step. You know, in medieval times, the degree of master was awarded as the title of master, which meant that you could teach at the university level. So, Dean Yurtsos, you got a few more teachers for next year, right? Oh, wait a minute. We don't expect masters to now be just teachers at universities. But your award of the degree that represents your mastering of some unique skills will come with responsibility to share that knowledge and to help others who aren't as gifted and as talented as you in their accomplishment of that mastering that skill. You completed this program in a really challenging time, and you should be proud of that accomplishment. I mean, how many people can say they completed a master's degree during a pandemic of the largest in 100 years? Truly, this means that this was a unique experience for you. And it means that regardless of what your expectations were when you started this process, it's likely different than what you got out of it. In fact, when you started the process, you might have asked yourself, should I get a master's degree? What do I expect to gain from a master's degree? The Association of American Colleges provides several reasons to get a master's degree. A higher salary, more opportunities, networking opportunities, curiosity, and the desire to learn. Well, for me, I pursued my advanced degree out of curiosity. I know it sounds crazy, but I was fascinated by the world of thermodynamics. Aren't you? So much so that I was willing to sacrifice other things. My ROTC instructors told me that delaying my military service could have a negative impact on my career. And I knew that I would probably have to delay any family plans that we had until I was finished. But when I finished that degree, I had no regrets. My time at Berkeley campus was one of the freest times, and it was filled with an amazing set of experiences across all aspects of my life, and not just thermodynamics, although it was really cool in thermodynamics too. But what about you? Why did you decide to pursue a master's at Viterbi? We heard from our commencement speaker what her thoughts were. And now that you're done, what do you think you got from it? Maybe you're not quite ready to answer that question yet, because it might take a little bit of time to fully understand and digest the experience of the last 2 to 3 years. I know for me, I still am, because when I accepted the position of a Judge Whitney professor in August of 2019, I did not have a pandemic on my radar scope. So if we look back over the last 2 years, we could focus on all the missed opportunities that were denied us because of the COVID-19 protection measures. We perhaps missed the benefits of networking with fellow students. And we certainly didn't get the face-to-face engagements with the esteemed faculty members that maybe we had hoped to get. Maybe some of us were just hoping to enjoy a little bit of the vibrance of the USC campus life. Instead, we spent more hours listening through headphones and staring at computer screens. And we all mastered the art of learning through den. But we were lucky. The rest of the campus was experiencing Zoom bombing during their classes. But instead of reflecting on the things we missed, let me suggest that you gained an experience that is going to make you a better STEM professional because of it. Because you had the opportunity to hone your resiliency skills as you learn to adapt and react to changes and obstacles while constantly moving forward. STEM professionals need resiliency skills as much as they need to understand physics and perform calculus. And each of us throughout our lives will experience times when things don't quite go the way we had planned. For me, I'll be honest, it was a couple of technology development efforts that kind of blew up on the launch pad instead of soaring into space. But we did eventually get there. And it was the loss of my husband far too soon. It could be a loss of a job, or it could be a relationship that doesn't happen, or an accident or an illness that leaves us with a disability. So resiliency is how we respond to these unexpected and continues, and then we continue to move forward. We have experienced that in spades in the last 3 years. We started with in-person classes. Then we went completely remote. And we had to experiment with different approaches to our home classroom. Perhaps you're an international student that had to face the challenge of not knowing whether you were going to be able to return, or you lost your financial aid. Maybe you had to juggle classes while homeschooling your children. Then victory was declared, and we returned to the classroom. And we had a campus which was spot dotted with COVID test sites, and we got the gift every morning of an email that would tell us, a message that would tell us whether we had been exposed by one of our classmates to COVID and would have to quarantine. What a great experience that was. And then Omicron variant hit, and we were back to our basements and our kitchen tables. But we finished with this celebration today, where I finally get to see your faces, and we get to be able to share in that networking, the opportunities that we didn't miss. We may have had the limited opportunities for networking, but we had a chance to meet members of our family and instructors' families who would pop into our WebEx classes. I know my SAE 549 class appreciated when my 2-year-old grandson announced to all that he had gone potty. And we found ourselves not just adapting once, but numerous times. I went on the website and I counted, there were no less than 100 notices on the COVID, the Trojan COVID website announcing changes to the school environment since the fall of 2020. So yes, you will not find resiliency on any of the course descriptions at Viterbi, but we all got lots of practical experience. And now you will be better in dealing with those upsets and obstacles you'll face in both your professional and personal life because you have had this experience. English writer Alan Watts said, "The only way to make sense out of change is to plunge into it, move with it, and join the dance." In the last 2 years, you all learned how to join the dance. When I was now that you've completed your training, what are you gonna do now? Are you rejoicing because now you'll get to do some of the things that you gave up while you were in class? Are you looking forward to starting a new job or a new position? After all, this is called a commencement ceremony, and that means it's a beginning, not an end. Indeed, it is a beginning for all of you because you have a new set of responsibilities now that you have the title of master. When I was completing my graduate degree, I overheard a conversation between my husband and his mother, my mother-in-law, and she was a very traditional Polish-American woman. She raised 7 children in a 2-bedroom house in Secaucus, New Jersey. And she asked my husband, she said, "When is Ellen going to stop working and let you take care of her?" My husband answered, "Mother, she will never stop working. She has a doctorate now, and she has an obligation to her profession to use that degree to help others." His answer hit me like a load of bricks because I had not recognized that obligation that obligation that comes with the knowledge that I had earned. From that day on, I made a vow to myself that whatever I did in my profession, that I would always strive to use my mastery of engineering to make the world a better place, better than the one that I found. As a military officer, I had 13 different moves and 21 different jobs over 36 years. I dealt with professional and personal tragedy, but I never forgot my vow to improve the life of those around me. Sometimes it was in the development of new capabilities that would protect our soldiers, sailors, airmen, Marines, and Coast Guardsmen. Other times, it was an effort to address the social injustice that I saw among the culture. But I never forgot that vow to improve their life. In fact, my decision to accept the Judge Whitney Professorship was part of my fulfillment of that vow, as I wanted to share forward to the next generation the experiences that I had as a scientist and as an engineer. In the granting of your master's degree today comes responsibility. Responsibility to your profession to uphold the high standards and of ethics and truth. Responsibility to society to use technology for the betterment of mankind. To add to those professional responsibilities, you are now all USC Trojans for life. And I don't know if you knew this, but do you know there's a Trojan code? How many of you knew there was a Trojan code? I don't see any hands raised. It's kind of like my den class, right? Nobody wants to talk. So let me read the Trojan code to you, because you all signed up for it. As a Trojan, I will always do what is right. I will act ethically, honestly, and fairly, and respect the rights and dignity of all people at all times. Nelson Mandela said, "What counts in life is not the mere fact that we have lived. It is what difference we have made to the lives of others that will determine the significance of the life we lead." We live in a world full of challenges and opportunities for scientists and engineers. Pandemics, climate change, social injustice, economic imbalance, inequality. Advances in technology will certainly impact our lives. The question is how. Will 5G and worldwide connectivity provide tools for autocratic governments to take away freedom? Or will they provide a means to correct the imbalances between those who have and those who have not? Will technology advance the negative effects of climate change? Or will it provide options to improve the world environment for all of us? And most importantly, in a world today where scientists and engineers have become the focus of conspiracy theories, can we restore the public trust in science and engineering? Today, you start a new phase in your life, and I challenge you to take that vow to make the world a better place. We know that we will face uncertainties and change, but you must join the dance. Fulfill your obligation to your profession, your obligation to your family and those who supported you to get to this point, and finally, your obligation to yourself. And I can't think of a more appropriate way to give you that challenge than to say, fight on, Trojan.
Thank you very much, General Polukowski. Graduates, as you prepare to enter the real world, remember that it grows more complex each day, and so do the challenges and opportunities that unfold before you. But you have studied the right disciplines for your time, and you are equipped with the best toolkit for the 21st century. As the late NA President Chuck Vest said at the USC Grand Challenges Summit in 2010, today, we live in the most exciting era for science and engineering in human history. So as you live today, this is our wish for you. Follow your heart, your intuition, and reach for the stars. And when you reach there, take a moment to look back, and you will see a caring and supporting institution that admires you, is proud of you, and embraces you for all the wonders you are certain to accomplish. Thank you. Congratulations and fight on.
Good afternoon, and now we're going to begin our ceremony. We're going to start with the students of Aerospace and Mechanical Engineering.
Austin Rosinka. Addison Kennedy Claiborne. Ram Sahinyan. Abhishek Singh. Birinder Singh. Rebecca Page Martin. Nicole Sophia Curtis Brown. Melody Haney. Songwei Lee. Sun Ray Lee. Anyang Zhang. Eng Kai Chen. Yuan Bo Ding. Derek Jinwei Lo. Lip Lung Won Siu. James Goldfield. Gregory James Leeson. Jack Tung. Amara Talverdian. Vinay Hachaturians. Bea Teresa Nava. Timothy Richard Udall. Miles Victor K. Avis Allen Fleming. Olin James Rogers. Jinkia Mahale. Salvatore Antonio Vitale. Ohan Kota.
Amy Jessica Gall.
Zachariah Yusefi Fand. Vanessa Diane Gonzalez. Erin Elise Bailey. Sri Pritam Sai Ravula. Alberto Parades. Austin Lee. Ryan Jacob Durkee.
Galen Naomi Takamoto.
Samantha Coe. David Alejandro Andaya. Hamden Lebo. Mason Westmoreland. Zijian Fang. Brandon Diaz. Alexander Robert Barata.
Harris Yunjong Chen. Ellen Mackenzie Whitaker the Fourth.
Lipso Pearl McDonald. Mine Badalian. Dania Alfarawi. Yutun Lee. Rafael Leonardo Antiveros Navarro. Matthew Lewis Ross. Miley McKen. Alex Trujillo Choquehuanta. Alejandro Gonzalez. Hector Jamie Fernandez Palacio. Magdalene LaRota. Didier Ivan Urego. Ian Hart.
June Wu. D. Young.
Ya Qi Li. Boris Chen. Boris Chen. Rio Amanda Menchaca. Greta Marie Rainey Studier. Jales Constantino Cotumbas.
Cameron Robert Hole.
Alexander Irving Vault. Eric Stanley Zamora. John Devatarnian. Zilong Li. Hong Dong In. Ihab Samir Ghanem. Tomas Salvador Seeger. Arpad Kovesdi. Matthew Navarro. Anish Matthews. Vadut Lotan Ahire. Atik Balkrishna Banagay.
And now we have the graduates from the Daniel J. Epstein Department of Industrial and Systems Engineering.
Shannon Marie Schweitzer Cioho. Shannon Marie Schweitzer Cioho.
You look good.
Patricia Garcia.
Jonathan Matthew Solomon. Carter Chase Julseth. Stephanie Michelle Thrift. Neil Grandjean. Miranda Costigan. Madeline K. Walter. Francesca Cecilia Pascage. Don Wei Lee. And you, Yao. And you, Ma. And Z Wen. In Jiet Song. Xiaohui Shen. Yuqing Xue. Xiaoyu Sun. Yanying Jiang. Chen Yuan Ge. Zhao Wei Guo.
Yifan Gwen.
Junjian Ken Lee. Rak Kudlawek Duarte Soto.
Vikram Kichirwal.
William Samuel Chit. Lilith Kirkasharian.
Bansi Siguna Yankichek Murthy.
Had Eloleon. Ingwen Yan. Jingzi Zhou. Jinyi Chen. Wei Yang. Don Long Wang. Yi Chun Hu.
Charles William Fisher.
Zhang Tao Wu. Amy Jessica Gall. Eileen Wong. Unkai Chi. Enbo Yang. Yiding Wong. Asim Masad Al-Johani. Abdul Majid Saeed Badada. Khaled Al-Sabi. Khalid Omar A. Jeffrey.
Mengxing Chen.
At Lertsakul Charun. Wen Chen. Ara Ahmed. Gui Yao Zhang. Serena Yao. Jin Yi Zhang. Eifan Tang. Zida Chen. Yao Xu. Wong. Lillian Simonian.
Juliana Tikota.
Xiao Nan Li. Ying Wang. Grace Williams. Anna Rebecca Mulroe. Marshall Shaw. Yuwen Ji. Christian Duran. Young Wong. Ya Liu. Oh, Lin. Ang Chi Xu. Eric Armin Hovanesian. Damian N. Yang Xie. Alea Rocknalden. Emil Connor. Sydney Lynn T. Fan Ni. Abhishek Mundra. Arjun Prinja. Jin Chao Sun. Rong Zhou. Ying U Yang.
Yu Chen Wang.
Ya Yin Li. Chao Kwai. Lin Xu.
I'd be wearing these. Tennis.
Ray Jane Liu. Celine An. Ing Yang Liu. Ing Jing Yang. Ben Zhang. Ellen Channing Montgomery. Inghao Chen. Yuan Qi Wei. Hao Hao Xia. Yuqing Shi.
Xin Yang Zhang.
Wan Xin Shu. Malia Lauren Sato. Neet Virupakshapa Angadi. Akarsh Nagraj. Ulisameka Stanley Afanta.
Aditya Suhas Joshi.
Saurabh Pagare. Bowen Feng. Yanshan Chen. Ingu Ling. Yu Yun Tsai. Yi Chen Yang. Naya Raisingani.
Galen Donat.
Saket Venkatesh. Artu Goriakin. Mario Alexander Königsberger.
And now the graduates from the Sony Astani Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering.
Wu Yue Ma. Zheng Xian Tan. Jia Yi Lan.
William Iro Pornodamari.
Bryston Skur. Andres Naftali Zasueta.
Veronica Erabedra.
Samuel Enrique Tejeda. Wei Lee.
Did you see
him?
Yeah, he's really too late.
He's the handsome one?
Yeah.
Miranda Isabella Leibig. Okay. Marco A. Valero. Amin Argand. Ibi Albedder. Duage Alsaba. Geg Agegian. Yusuf Al-Ahmed. Russell James Rapp. Yijie Zhang. Hongxun Yang. Dang Lu. Zhang Lin Li. Xiao Ling Yang. Amanda Savis Molayem. Vishnu Jitendra Tejani. Insoo Kim. Yi Kun He. Ray Xin Xu. Yi Han Yu. Ahmad Al Rafai. Taif Akil A. Almatiari. Mohammed Al Nuahid.
Igerem Moldasheva.
Shang Zhang. Cao Yang Li. Yun Jie Luo. David Askins Gast. Dalina Anastasia. Debbie Cynthia Putri. Wan E. Long. Bianca Francesca Costa. Noor Al Riami. Luis Angel Hernandez. Amal Al Hamidi. Fami Isam Mashhur. Khaled Abu Melha. Ali Hussein Alataz. Ali Ibrahim Al Shakak. Mishari Habib Al Mishari. Diego Javier Jacome. Ashish Brahambat. Hussein Alayathan. Jamal Al Said. Aysel N. Al Kurin. Tarek Mubarak Al Dosari. Imad Mahmoud Gaud. Abdul Latif Alosabi. Lukun Song. Onyuan Lu. Ipo Tu. Erwin Huang. Kunsili. Xin Shan. Ye Tian.
Met Otun. And now we have our graduates from the Ming She Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering.
Surya Dev Singh Nera. Samuel Franklin Chase. John Abraham Syed. Catherine Marietta Amin. Yen Shi Dong. Victor Chin. Ang Qing Xu.
Quan Jiang.
Zhou Hao Fang. Ai Jing Gao. Zhen Xuan Tao. Xiao Chu. William Heijun Haley. Zhao Chen Li. Zi Ming Shen. Yi Tong Liu. Ayang Jiang. Abdul Rakaz Altuani.
Karapet Manukian.
Hamza Hayat Ghani. Mandeep Vash. Neeraj Rani. Ishan Shah. Ula Boye. Snigdam Ruta Devulapali. Neha Gedam. Eris Atwan. Nayef Sayud Al Hajraf. Ishan Pradeep Joshi. Ruti Balchandra Limaye. Aswin Gopikana. Bhavna Veluvulu. Aishwarya Kasim. Seth Krieger. Four Nee. Aiting Diao. Deng Liu. Jin Hong Liu. Yu Fan Zhang. Yu Hang Hu. Ying Feng Lou. Qu Li. Ashnun Saqib.
Asiman Nishatvar.
Reed W. Riley. Jason Schwartz. Arvind Arnasalam. Yush Pandey.
Sun Min Lee.
Yash Seti. Agastya Gogoi. Naman Mahotra. Shubham Gupta. Danyang Lee. Ya Chen Ji. Yao Ting Wu. 领驾证. Hangxi Wu. Deng Rongli. Ding Rui Huang. Yi Xiao Li. Nia Kachi Eluagu. Li Jia Tong. Anton Alexander Hood. Ming Han Gao. Qi Meng Zhao. Ian Dominguez. Michael Fong. Diti Hoskere Deepak. Rujana Subramania. Chirag Ranoji.
Trisha Sinha.
Man Bawa. Rohit Sirang Kane. Rahanaz Anwar Sheikh. Danket Patnaik. Ditya Sahu. Ihan Wang. Jia Wei Xiang. In Xin Hu. Tao Qi. Ya Han Wang. Yuan Yu Zhu. Xiao Chuan Tong. Ya Qi Lai. Lakshmi Sanja Ramesh. Michael Bertrand Posey. Mali Paresh Munshi. Anisha Gupta. Isha Shrikant Kulkarni. Sihui Li. Christopher Jack Gerhardt. Benjamin James Brooks. Gabriel Jacob Katz. Amia Ahmadi. Zhi Jin. Neat AC. Avni Mangesh Kasture. Agati Kurapati. Yash Sahai. Avinash Paga. Iva Teja Tema Naboina. Nainzar Kent. Justin Thomas Wilford. Ray Chi Zhang.
Yuan Shan Lu.
Yan Song. Carla Alejandra Lopez Sanchez. Ora Chen Cao. Theodore Clerman Lewitt.
Oscar Bashaw.
Yen Song. Anirudh Sharad. Yunqin Chen. Ina Niknajad. Jeff Tsui. Aaron Te Xi Xu. San He Wan. Try Xu. Yahui Zhang.
Ming Hao Jiang.
Yun Yan Zhu. Hong Jiao Men. Yi Zi Guo. Ta Lu Chen. Guo Liang Song. Fa Lao. Ya Cheng Ren. Ning Zhu.
Yuan Fong.
Hong Xu. Arsha Raidurgam Venkat. Ditan Jyoti. Jia Shu Dong. Yao Fu. Hua Cheng Dong Liu. Yao Wei Guo. Yu Yao Yang. Yi Ran Jiang. Ray Jie Zhu. Ba Hua Li. Quan Zhang. Yu Zhou Qin. Amjad Aryan. Yiran Xu. Rick Chaffee. 君与留。今晚三民主力一川市焦旭谷于希望易飞生永金林
Jesus Rodolfo Juan Contreras
Min He Hong Hao Yuan Zhang Jane Hollingsworth Carpenter Akshata Anil Konan Tambigi Luke Grantham Yi Chen
Yi Hua Zheng Xin Chu Zhang
Yan Yu Li Jiao Yu Fan Ray Yu Li Yi Xuan Xu Viola Shi Ai Ying Sun Jin Zhang
You work in the night shift?
Ruo Yu Han Guo Liu 为嘉许。
Lu Yang Chang.
Yu Xing Zhang.
And now we have our graduates from the Green Technologies Program.
Michael Markel Simpson. Evan Joseph Warasilla.
Brittany Gallivan.
Jackson Adam Carroll. Ellie Tan Strathoff.
And now, our graduates from the Department of Astronautical Engineering.
Shirley Alexandi. Richard Hayden Burns. Ashant Pratek Prasad. Evan Sharp Rosenthal. Jonathan Cook Viet Nguyen. David M. Gutierrez. Nicholas Noel. Dante de Jesus Dorantes. Jacqueline Stefan. Jaina Scott Goldberger. Jared William Miller. Alvin N. Chan. Henrik Chan. Elizabeth Yu. Daniel Brogan. Taylor Holston Gaines. John David Barkfelt. Cullen C. Blyler. Nicholas Ray Borquez. Samuel Jacob Noy. Demetrius Emmanuel Morales. Spencer Waddell. Siddhant Prasad Chandgadar. Oren Mercedes Kafadarian. Evan A. Palmer. John Douglas Wong Rogers. Kellen Bruce Cook. Reese Phipps. Derek James Janoski. Winique Din. Michael Lucci. Huyen Nhong Nguyen. Noki Sanjay Kolodwala. Lance Stephen Mayhew. Michael Hamilton Smatt. Rafael Ortega. Carlos Marin. Amelia Asghari. Anthony Peters. Lucas Paul McClelland. Ulrad Kempe.
And now our graduates from the Systems Architecting and Engineering program.
Miguel Alejandro Barbosa Courtright. Jessica Lum Wing Ma. Alexandra Corey Payson Yulin. Ryan Richard Luton. Arla Ueda. Stephanie Morgan Uloa Chavez.
Next. No, Michael.
Victoria Beatrice Roberta Ward.
Jeffrey Willis.
Gabriel Sagbini. Ars Alos. Nicholas Hansen. Paul Zhu. Jordan Miller. Joshua Timms. Aaron Chandra. Ryan Harut Markanian. Reginald Ginto. Jared Manolo Kaylee Pangolinan.
Yasmin Martin. Andrew Martin. And now the graduates from the Department of Biomedical Engineering.
Jasmine May Rizko. Steffi K. Kwok. Julie Ann Hope Johnson. Andrew Gordon Yock. Isabel Dulagia. Liam Mora. Amber Louise Helton. Yun Xiong. Annie Yen.
John David Lin.
Alice Jane Bobovich. Emily Jane Kong. Sydney Michelle Mayer. Paul Yen Yim.
Jan Lau.
Dario Urbina Melendez. Albina Yesan Kwak. Eureka Tortia. Evan Patolia.
Jason Tran.
Eris Marie Blass. Olivia Marie Pereira.
And now our graduates from the Mork Family Department of Chemical Engineering and Material Science.
Deming In. Shen Han Guan. Yu Jie Song. Rabia Ghulam Ali. Yi Tao Shen. Scott Cummings. Kristen Corrine McPhail. Qi Jian Deng. Owen Xu. Dong Yu Chen. Chen Ling Zhong. Yi Wen Chen. Tang Yu Yang. He Yang.
And now our graduates from the Petroleum Engineering Program.
Yan Wei Li.
Nima Danishwarnajad.
Yan Wei Li.
Nima Danishwarnajad.
Tian Wei Li.
Huda Rajab Elenzi.
Uluwatomisen Soyebo. Peter Adiola Durosinmi. Anwal Gupta. Alfredo Ocando Marquez.
Let's give all our graduates a final round of applause.
Congratulations, graduates, and thank you to all the family and friends that are here today. You all played a critical part in the achievements of all of our wonderful graduates. It is now my pleasure to present to you the greatest marching band in the history of the universe, the USC Marching Band. Thank you so much for everyone's attention. Please remain in your seats while the platform party recesses from the arena. guests, we ask that you do not attempt to enter the arena floor. Please meet your graduate on campus, as there is another ceremony right after this one. Thank you, everyone. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and fight on.